Hello, everybody, and welcome to another episode of Back to Basics. Today, I think we are going to go on an adventure, so let's go ahead and prep for that while I tell you a little bit about what we're looking for. We are looking for, obviously, some more resources. Iron is very important to us, but there is something that we have not seen yet, which is coal. Now, I figured if we find a naturally spawning cave, we will do much better at finding a lot of these resources, because those veins are a lot easier to find when using those resources. Let's go ahead and cook a little bit of this meat up. Just a few more pieces in here, and this should be fine. And we'll also go ahead and make ourselves another pickaxe, because this one's getting a little bit damaged. And we will be able to use it when we go mining. Let's go ahead and check on that mutton. Nice. We'll just wait on the other piece, and then we will get off on our adventure. It's still not nighttime. I don't think we're going to wait till nighttime and then sleep and then go out right away. I think we're just going to go out. We're going to go for a walk, though. We're not going to actually go on a boat. We're going to try to find a land-based cave system as opposed to swimming up to one and then climbing in the cave. Let's wait on this piece of chicken here. We'll take this birch wood back. Now, the things I like to carry with me when we go out adventuring are some extra wood. Very important. Obviously, a pickaxe, a sword, and then I usually like to take armor. Oh, look at me. Look at me. I usually like to take armor, but obviously, we don't have enough resources for it, so we are not going to be using any right now. The last thing I like to take are usually torches, but because we don't have coal, we'll be able to make torches on the go with our birch wood. And the final thing is a bucket of water. Now, water can be used, obviously, to scale objects, so I'll go ahead and show you guys that right now. So let's say I need to go up here, right? I can swim up with spacebar, I can right click the water, and then I can click the next block, and then I can click the next block up here, and I can wait for that. I can swim up that, and that's how you can climb if you're in like a deep hole or something, or you can use it as a control fall. You won't take damage if you jump into water. I'll go ahead and show you that now. So boom, jumped into water, absolutely safe. So that's another thing you should keep in mind when you're cave diving. Oh, and it looks like we have one of our melon plants already growing. That is very awesome. So we're going to go over here. Let's go ahead and see if we can't find a cave system. We'll run along the land just so we can speed up the process, because swimming is a little bit slow. There are a lot of cool mods for Minecraft that will make swimming a little bit better, but like I said, I wanted to keep this very vanilla. I wanted to keep this very traditional to the game. Water is definitely not a place you want to run into skeletons, for sure, because skeletons obviously have a ranged attack and they can just keep hitting you and hitting you while you're trying to swim away. It looks like we might have something over here. We do! Okay, this is kind of a little cave system. Oh, and will you listen to that? Oh, and look! Ready? Listen. They have lovely Minecraft music. They've kept it the same since vanilla, I think, or since the first release. They just changed, they added some songs, I believe. I don't think they removed many songs. Very melodic music, very, very soothing music to go along with you while you mine. And here we have our first show of coal. Obviously, when you mine coal, you get experience right away because it turns straight into coal. Coal can be increased, the amount you pick up, with a fortune enchantment on pickaxes. And for the reason that coal turns straight into coal once you mine it, the blocks turn straight into the actual ore, you get experience right away. Now, they don't do that with iron, because then you can just keep laying down iron and keep picking it back up and get a little bit of experience each time from that. So they make it so that you get experience from smelting. Here's a little bit more coal, which is awesome, and a very interesting looking tree. I don't know how that happened up there, but... Oh, have you guys ever seen those pictures? It's a gravestone, right? But there was a tree planted, like, right next to it, apparently, when the person passed away. And the tree actually, like, ate the gravestone, and, like, you can just see the corner of the gravestone. I thought it was a very, very cool picture. I think I actually went to go see it at one point. I saw it in Ripley's Believe It or Not, one of those books, a long time ago. And that was a huge vein of coal. We are doing very well on the coal now. Now we can start cooking things. We can do what I said we were going to do in the beginning of the episode. We'll go ahead and make ourselves some torches. Now we can go in deep caves. Come on. Oh, hey, we got a sapling for breaking that. That can happen, obviously. Yeah, let's keep going. Home is that way, I remember. I hope I remember. There are ways to make compasses to know where your spawn point was, but it only points at the spawn point you had started with. Oh, hey, a pig. Let's go look at the pigs. Okay, so pigs are obviously pigs, and they drop pork chops when you kill them. You can also ride them with a saddle and use carrots on a stick in order to make them run a little bit faster. There we go. We'll kill one. We got two pork chops. Very awesome. Anyway, and there's a way to make a compass in order... Oh, hey, this is probably where we spawn because we left this here. Remember, I don't like leaving floating trees. It just looks very unnatural. So we'll go ahead and pull that down. It does not look like we found a cave, an underground cave, in time. So we'll take some of these two tall flowers, which are peonies. And these are rose bushes, I believe. And we'll head back home, I guess, for the time being, or what is our home. Oh, that really makes me mad. Maybe we will go by sea for the tomorrow. But let's go ahead and try to make it home before it really sours here and we run into a ton of mobs and we can't defend ourselves. I'm going to run along the shore, obviously, because I know our house is along the shore here. If you're wondering how I'm sprinting, if that's something that you haven't figured out yet, it's just double tapping the forward button. A lot of people like to set sprint as its own button so that it's just easier to turn on and off. Me, I just keep it nice and vanilla. And then you're probably wondering why I'm jumping. Well, the jumping, it makes you run faster, but it also uses more hunger. So you have to be careful about it. So when you're trying to get somewhere fast, obviously you're going to want to run and jump. Oh, and we have our first zombie drop. Now, rotten flesh is something that will fill your hunger bars. But the problem is, oh, and there's a creeper. Let's go ahead and get in the house. Awesome. Oh, there are monsters nearby. So that's good. Is there something down here? Nope. Okay, we're good. So it's probably just that creeper outside. Anyway, I'll explain rotten flesh first. So rotten flesh is something that can fill your hunger bar, but it also causes hunger. I'll go ahead and show you guys that. There. Now we have the hunger aspect on us for 30 seconds. That usually drops, I think, 3.5 to 4 pieces of hunger, and we'll just be able to fill that back up with cooked chicken. Let's go ahead and see if we can sleep now. Oh, and we can. Good. So, yeah, as you saw, when creepers or skeletons or zombies are too close to your bed, it'll give you that message that they're too close and you need to go kill them. A lot of people avoid this by putting their beds in the center of their houses, and there's probably a creeper out there. Okay, we are out of hunger, so apparently the amount of saturation that was given from the rotten flesh was enough to keep us alive or to keep us from going under the full hunger. Okay, here we go. 1, 2. Yes, we got him. And then this is a baby zombie. They are much faster than the zombie, but their tracking is a little bit different than a regular zombie's would be. Let's take care of this creeper real quick. Nice. We got our first drop from a creeper. I thought I heard another one. I was a little bit scared. Okay, why do we have 3 baby zombies? Okay, a problem with baby zombies is they don't burn it in the daytime, obviously. They don't have fire on them. I don't know why that is or what the reasoning behind it is. But it looks like we've cleaned up our home, hopefully. Awesome. Our wheat is starting to grow. I wonder if we... No, I don't think we've killed enough skeletons for something that I wanted to show, but that is all right. Let's go ahead and take some of these flowers and go plant them outside. No real reason, just so it looks nice. We'll put that rotten flesh away because we don't need that. And this is gunpowder. Gunpowder can be used. It's dropped from creepers, and it can be used to create TNT, which I'm sure I'll be able to show off eventually. And I'm sure a lot of you would like to see it shown off because TNT is always fun to play with. Unless it's in real life, then that's just scary. So let's go ahead and plant a couple of these so we can see our house from a distance. No like real specific spot. We'll just, that looks nice. Like I said, this is not our permanent home, so we don't really need to make it perfect. Let's go ahead and put this iron ore in here. Now, coal will actually cook 8 pieces of whatever's in there with 1 piece of coal. So we'll just leave that in there. And then additionally, you can make coal blocks by putting a 3x3 in a crafting bench. The coal block, I believe, will cook... I don't know if it's 64. No, I don't think it's a stack. I think it's more than a stack. Plus, so it'd be 9 times 8 is, what, 72. And then I think it does 8 more than that, too. So it'd be 81. I believe. I'll have to check my facts on that. We're going to go take on the skeleton. Remember what I said? Skeletons are very OP when in water because they can just turn you and shoot you away from them when you try to push up on them. But we went ahead and went after that one because we are looking for a drop that they have not given us yet, unfortunately. But we'll survive, obviously. Oh, setting down. Nope. Don't want to set down the water. Like I said, the water physics in this game, very peculiar still. We're going to go ahead and eat some of this cooked chicken. And let's go swim out to our boat and we will... follow the shore. Hopefully, maybe we'll see something cool, or at least a cave system that we can see from the shore. So we're gonna just come down this way. Remember, home's right over there. It's no big deal. We'll remember. If anything, we'll just follow the shoreline back, and we'll see the R that we had placed up there before. Oh, and what is this? Okay, so that is a water temple, I believe. No, that's a jungle temple. That is very, very, very cool. I've actually never run into these in the wild before. Oh, let's get out and explore. Okay, so the idea with a water temple is, or not a water temple, jungle temple, is that there is a trap. There's traps inside of it. And we'll go ahead and just jump up here. There's traps inside of it. But let's go ahead and make sure it's well lit so we don't run into any mean monsters while we're here. Because that is something that we do not want. Let's go ahead and light this up. Now, sometimes there are zombies or skeletons in here. Nothing to be afraid of. Okay, now, I'm going to show you this just for testing purposes. Now, you walk in here, right? And that arrow fires at you. You see that arrow coming out of that dispenser over there? That's because of this tripwire trap. Now, in order to make a tripwire trap, you need string and tripwires. Tripwire hooks. Using redstone and tripwire hooks, you can make plenty of traps, actually. You see, this is covering this dispenser that was firing arrows at us. Nice 10 arrows for us. And we'll also take the dispenser with us just in case we need it. And we could take some of this redstone. Oh, there's another trap right there. You see it? So if we grab that, then it can't hurt us anymore. Let's go ahead and take both hooks again. Take some of this redstone. Oh, and we'll take some of those arrows. We'll clear that, and we get some treasure. Ooh, gold! Very awesome. And this is the drop that I wanted to get from the skeletons. It is, we have 9 bones. I'll explain those in a little bit. We're gonna go ahead and grab this chest as well, because why not? And the dispenser, because why not? It's very good to save as much as you can, because you never know when you're gonna need it. We're gonna take all of this. Now, this next part of this build is a little bit different. I believe there's redstone back in here to trip that one, if I am correct. I don't know how they did it. Uh-oh. No. Okay. It doesn't matter. We got enough we have enough redstone for now, and we can always find it as a natural resource. Okay, so this is a puzzle. The puzzle, if you do it correctly, I got it right, the first guess, I believe. Maybe not. Let's go ahead and do it again. Okay, we'll go check over here now. Yeah, if you do it correctly, it should open up some pistons, and it will reveal some chests. It may be that it's bugged, but the idea is that, obviously, if you don't guess correctly, you won't get what you wanted. But there's an easy way around it, which is mine. See? That easy. We'll just take this. We'll take these. Sticky pistons are always useful. You never know when you're going to want one. It looks like this block would have opened up. Oh, yeah. I didn't walk over it or anything, did I? Interesting. Anyway, so then there's another one. Ooh, we got an emerald. Emeralds are very cool. They'll be obviously explained further down the road when we have more use for them. This is mossy cobble. Mossy cobble, I believe, can be made now. I'm not 100% sure on it, but I believe in 1.8 they implemented a way to create it. Home is that way, I believe, so just trying to remember. And actually, we will head that way because there's a few things I wanted to show you. Oh, and right here, actually. Oh, no, we don't have a shovel, but that's clay. We'll get into clay, obviously, further down the road as well. When we start building our house, I don't have an idea for our house yet, but if you guys want to start suggesting themes for our home, I'd be very much into that. I want to hear what you guys want to see. And let your imaginations run wild, really. Like a water park. You know what I mean? Like something crazy like that. Because I can do builds, and then what I'll probably end up doing is time-lapsing it, but we will collect the resources together. And if it's resource-intensive, obviously, I'll collect the resources and then time-lapse that as well, so it goes a little bit quicker. There goes our boat, obviously, because that's going to keep happening. We are going to just keep the dispensers. I don't know if we're going to set up a trap for them yet. We'll keep the emerald, and we have gold, which is very cool, just something that I want to show you, and bones is something else I want to show you. We'll keep our tripwire trap out. We'll just clean up this inventory a little bit. Oh, and we have more chests for more space. Now, you can't stack, you can't put a chest here and open it because there's a block above it, obviously. So what you're going to need to do is you're going to need to obviously make a new area for your chest. And that's not where we're going to put it because that's probably a bad choice. It's probably how we're going to get killed. So what we'll do is we'll just store this chest inside of a chest, chestception. For the time being, and then we'll go ahead and figure what we're going to do with that later. Just making sure we didn't need to eat. Let's go ahead and go over here, and I wanted to show you the next thing. This is bone. These are bones, obviously. Bones, I don't really think they have a use other than doing this, and it creates bone meal. Bone meal is both the white dye that you can combine with other dyes in order to make light-colored dyes, and it also helps grow crops. So if we right-click this one that hasn't grown at all, we'll usually see some green sparkles, and then depending, it's a random tick and a random amount, but you get fully grown stalks. Now, stalks are the only thing you're going to get because the melons actually take a period of time to grow. So we'll go ahead and do that here with these ones too. And there we have another fully grown stalk. Very awesome. And then I'll show you on this, you get a tick each time. Let's go ahead and make a little bit more, and hopefully we can get our first instance of wheat. There we go. That is fully grown wheat. We will go ahead and harvest that. Now we get two seeds and a piece of wheat from that. So let's go ahead and set down those two seeds. Awesome. And we will bone meal those up as well. Get even more seeds from that. We got three seeds and three pieces of wheat. And then we'll just let these grow from now on. We won't keep farming that, obviously. But that's how bone meal works. You can also use bone meal on trees and all other growable foods. As well as flowers, it will spawn more flowers. And you can use bone meal, I should probably show this off, on the ground, and it will give you more grass in the area. So if you want to get more seeds really quickly, you can do that. And it will give you the native flower for the area, or at least it should. We'll go ahead and plant these two as well. And now we will show you just a couple more things here. First, we have our pieces of wheat. And if we put three pieces of wheat in a row like this, we get our bread. And that should bring up our next achievement, which it does. We'll go ahead and go into achievements. And it says, bake bread. Turn wheat into bread. Awesome. We got that one. So we'll go ahead and... Bread is obviously edible. I don't know why you don't have to cook it in the oven. It's just something that's been around for a long time. Now, the next couple recipes are very important and very good to remember. We are going to make a T pattern without the middle, obviously, or a cross pattern without the middle. And then we're going to take redstone and we're going to put it in the middle. Now, this makes us a compass. Like I said, a compass will tell us exactly where home is. Where we spawned was. So if we end up where we spawned, we'll obviously be able to find home, or as long as you build home close to spawn, you should be able to do so. Let's go ahead and go back to sleep. Okay, now that it is morning again, we will create our last item, which is the same pattern, except using gold this time. Now, this will create a clock. The clock can be used when you're down in the mines and you need to know what time it is and know if you should come to the surface yet. Because obviously there are going to be mobs on the surface at nighttime. If you come up at the wrong time, you don't want to be caught, you know, and then worry about having to fight mobs on your way home. You're rather going to stay down in the mines for a little bit longer, keep mining, keep the torches going, and then once you know it's daytime, you go out and you adventure back home so that you don't die. Makes sense, right? Yeah. Okay. So we got some awesome pork chops. We have our coal, which we will go ahead and cook some more of our food and things right now. And then I don't know if there's any more resources we need to cook right now. It should be mentioned that gold can be used to make golden apples. Actually, I believe we have an apple, don't we? Did I eat it? No, I didn't. Good. Okay, so golden apples can be made two ways. I don't think the nuggets make a golden apple. I'm not 100% sure on it. We'll check. Obviously, no, they don't. Okay, so you need pure gold. You need to use either gold bricks or blocks of gold. Blocks of gold make, I believe, a god apple, or I can't remember. There's an achievement for it here if we go ahead and check. Here we go. Overpowered. Yeah, build a notch apple. My bad. And that's what we do with our gold. So now we have a clock. We have this. So next time we go on an adventure without that dungeon that we found, which is actually very amazing that we found. I'm very surprised about it. We will go out and we will go underground. We will find some more resources because we do need a little bit more iron. We need maybe some more gold. Maybe we'll try to find some emeralds. And we seek out the illustrious or the well. I don't know. It's diamonds. We're looking for diamonds is what I'm trying to say. We're gonna go look for some diamonds and some everything. And that's what Minecraft's based off is obviously mining, hence Minecraft, and then building with those tools and things that we have mined. Doesn't look like we have any melons. But yeah, that'll be the end of the episode, you guys. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, please remember to hit that like button. If you're new to the channel, please remember to hit the subscribe button. And let me know what you want to see. If there's something in the game that you want me to see, you want me to show off, please don't be afraid to let me know in the comment section down below. Thank you very much for your time, and you have a great day.